People have the idea that a local minimum means the function decreases and then increases. Here's a local minimum on the graph of this random function, and the misconception is that they all look like this, that every time you've got a local minimum, on one side the function's decreasing and on the other side the function's increasing. Plenty of local minima do look exactly like that, but there's also plenty of pathological examples. For instance, consider this somewhat pathological example. I'm going to define this function f as a piecewise function. If the input's non-zero, I'm going to do this. 1 plus the sine of 1 over x, which makes sense since x isn't 0, times x squared. And if the input is 0, the function's output will also be 0. In this case, there's a local minimum at 0. How do I know? Well, here's how I know. Let's take a look at this function. The claim is that f of x is never negative. How do I know that? Well, what do I know about sine? Sine of absolutely anything at all, no matter what I take the sine of, is between minus 1 and 1. Now, if I add 1 to this, 1 plus sine of absolutely anything at all is between 0 and 2. Now that's pretty good. Now think back to the definition of this function. Here I've got 1 plus sine of something, doesn't matter what. Right? 1 plus sine of anything, this is between 0 and 2. Now I'm multiplying it by x squared. What do I know about x squared? Well, x squared is not negative. Could be 0, could be positive, but no matter what x is, x squared is not negative. Now I'm multiplying 1 plus sine of 1 over x, this number which is trapped between 0 and 2, by x squared, which is never negative. And that means f of x is not negative as long as x isn't equal to 0. Right, as long as x isn't equal to 0, I'm in this first case, and this is a non-negative number times a non-negative number, so the product is also non-negative. Now the other possibility, of course, is that I plug in 0 for x, but then f of 0 is just by definition 0, and that means in either case, no matter what I plug in for x, f of x is never negative. Now if f of x is never negative and f of 0 is equal to 0, then I know that this must be the smallest possible output value for the function. The only numbers that are smaller than 0 are negative numbers, and the output of this function is never negative. But this isn't the usual sort of local minimum where the function just decreases and then increases. Well, here's the graph for a function f. And there is a local minimum at 0, but if I start zooming in, no matter how much I zoom in, there's no little region on which the graph is just decreasing and then increasing. The graph is always wiggling. The upshot here is that decreasing and then increasing is one way to produce a local minimum, but it's not the definition of a local minimum, and not every local minimum arises in that exact way. What a local minimum means is just that no nearby output value is smaller than that local minimum value.